All right, this is what we've been working towards all year with Banjo Blitz, and it's what I call thumb lead for Clawhammer Banjo. Now, it's not written about in any of the instructional materials that I know, though there are plenty of players who do this. I use it extensively, and it allows me to escape the downbeat-oriented sound that typical Clawhammer tends to have. Now, if you're feeling like this is a little bit out of your reach right now because you're not quite caught up in all the Banjo Blitz episodes, that's okay. Watch this video anyway because it can show you what you're hearing in your favorite players playing. And then you can go back and refine the technique in earlier Banjo Blitz episodes and work your way up to thumb lead. All right, so here we go. Thumb lead for Clawhammer Banjo. Welcome to Banjo Blitz. All right, we're starting with a very simple pattern for thumb lead. It's not going to sound like much in the beginning, but over the course of the next several videos, we'll transform it into a true thumb lead technique. Now, if you stick with me till the end of this video, I do have a challenge for Banjo Blitz viewers. I hope some of you will take this up, so stay tuned in till the end. All right, first here is the simple pattern. There's no M skips. This is all downstrokes, all double thumbing. Let's break this down real quick. Downstroke on your open third string followed by a fifth string. Then a drop thumb on your first and third open strings. Then two ditties on your open first string. So again, nice and slow. Use your deep listening skills, concentrate, get all of those notes sounding the same volume. This is just an eighth note pattern. Get those eighth notes right. Then, once you feel comfortable with this, you're going to move to the next step. The next step is to start dropping notes out. We're going to use the M skip technique to do this. So the overall effect you're going for is going to sound like this. So your first two notes stay the same, a downstroke on the open third string followed by a fifth string. Then you're going to do that drop thumb on the open first and third strings, but you are going to intentionally miss the open first string. Then you're going to do a ditty, but you're going to intentionally miss the downstroke of the ditty. And then you finish it off with the ditty on the first and fifth strings. Nice and slow again, it is. All right, let me speed this up for you. A little bit faster. And let me see if I can get this thing rolling. All right, really tough. Take your time, spend time with the initial pattern, then start leaving notes out. Here is my challenge for you as a Banjo Blitz viewer. For the month of January 2018, if you can get a video up on YouTube of yourself playing a Banjo Blitz pattern in January 2018, I will review the video and I will give you tips and tricks and my idea of what you need to do next in your playing to advance your playing. It will be like having a private lesson with me, except it will be for free. So you can get my feedback that way just for the month of January. So get these videos out there. Don't be afraid. Just put them out there. Put yourself out there. It'll be good for you. Recording yourself, remember, is an excellent way to get an understanding of your own technique. So this is my way of pushing some of you guys to get recordings of yourself so you can take a look at your own technique, and I will take a look at it with you. All right, that about does it. If you have questions, comments, please leave them below, and I will see you next week for more thumb lead clawhammer on Banjo Blitz.